My name is Akshayaa Venkatakrishnan, and I teach high school science at Dater High School. I came to UC to be in an 8-year medical program, so I really was fixated on going into healthcare, and I realized pretty early on that I love science, but I didn't want to be a doctor. I took a couple classes with really good professors, and so I started thinking, wouldn't it be cool to teach in this way? Being a Bearcat buddy at UC, being a part of the RAP program at UC, those are all experiences where a lot of my peers influenced me and made me realize that being in the classroom was the route that I wanted to take. I signed up for a random honor seminar my first year of college because I needed the credit, and Dr. G was the professor. He really inspired me to start thinking about the world in terms of all of these fields I was always interested in, but interweaving them and seeing how they relate to each other. And that's what really sparked my love for environmental science.
She was a student in a course that I teach occasionally called Climate Change, Think Globally, Act Locally, and Akshayaa was one of the best students in the course.
Dr. G comes in once a week with UC students. We work together to teach students different aspects of designing experiments, all interwoven with environmental science. Projects like the one that Dr. G is helping us with, the biochar project, it brings science to life for students. It's not just graphs on a page. It's not just information your teacher's telling you.
The goal of the biochar project was to bring hands-on science to Cincinnati Public Schools and have it be hands-on science that was related in some way to climate change. I mean, they literally get their hands dirty.
You get to play a role in making something better, and I think that's so exciting for students, and it makes learning so much more sticky in their minds. I think Dater students are extremely resilient. They have a lot of barriers that we see in a lot of Cincinnati public schools, things like worrying about nutrition and transportation and housing, immigration. All of those things are real for a lot of students in our country right now, everywhere, and they're especially real here. My students are intelligent and funny and curious and so talented. In my classrooms, I see students that UC would be lucky to have, like some great future Bearcats. My honors students are going to be visiting the honors program at UC in October. There's all these connections that we have right here in our community, and it's great that we can make it accessible for our students. Cincinnati and being a Bearcat played such a role in who I became and who I wanted to be, and it only made sense for me to stay here and continue being a part of this community, and I'm so thankful to be a part of Cincinnati Public Schools too as a Bearcat. I'd like to start off the year telling them I started college in this program, I thought I was going to be a doctor, and I realized that that wasn't where my passion was, and I think that shows students that it's okay to change your mind. It's okay to persevere and find other options. It's okay not to know. Sometimes it just takes the right place to kind of serve as the catalyst to move you to where you want to be. And I think that's what UC was for me, and I hope all my students have that same experience. Hopefully it's Bearcats, but wherever they want to go, it's fine.